Thanks a lot. Yeah, so let's start a session, okay? So welcome all, first of all. So this is our GLUG PhD online session. So here today we are going to discuss hosting a Pelican site on GitLab, like how do you host it? So how do you have your site on a server? And there's a small discussion on CryptPad, okay? So that's the plan for today. And what we thought we can possibly deliver today to you guys was, we were thinking that let's have a session where this will be like the final session for Pelican. So the three subparts, among the three subparts, this is a final session for Pelican. So in the first session, we took we got to know how Pelican, like what Pelican is. Then we got into the basic installation, configurations. Then we did some configurations on GitLab. Okay. So initial setups basically. Then the next session we started installing Pelican. We started working with Pelican. The whole setup, the Pelican setup was done. And we went a step ahead and we tried to even run Pelican site on a local server, right? So yes, that we did start with Git last time, but I would like to again do it this time because it's very important, okay? Git is actually important in this case because we're going to host it live, fine? So that's what has happened till now, the date, to be honest. So in previous session, to be specific, like what we did was, we first installed Pelican. So it's pip install Pelican, then we install Markdown. So it's pip install Markdown. Then there's a keyword, okay? So there's a command, Pelican hyphen quick start. So this command, what it does is it generates the files. It generates the sites ka files, okay? So let's say Pelican is the site. For this site, it generates all the required files, fine? And how does it generate? Based on few questions. So it prompts some questions to us. Based on the answers given to the questions, we get the site generated, okay? Among this, like there's the three things that is very important. That is, who's the author? Who's the author for the blog site? Okay, second thing, the name of the blog. I mean, the name of the site. Okay, in our case, it was GLUG PEC's blog, okay? And the last thing was just URL, okay? And if we give these three things, we will have the initial setup done completely, right? Then all others can have the default values. So that's what the Pelican quick setup, quick start does, right? So then what we did was we went on to create a blog post. So the first post, that's what we created in the last session. Then it was in a Markdown file. So we got to know what is the basic syntax that we have to start with. So without that syntax, our blog post won't be viewed or won't be generated on the site. Why? Because that file has the title. That file has something known as slug. Slug is nothing but if you run the file, like what happens is this MD file is there, no? This Markdown file is there, no? This Markdown file gets converted into an HTML file. As I have been telling you, Pelican does this job. It takes the input in Markdown or text. It converts. It has a template where it converts this Markdown file into an HTML file. Okay. So all websites are under HTML, right? So it's like glug.pac.html. That's what the URL usually be. Right. So in this case, what happens is the title, the slug and all that, you know, they all are required. To be specific about a slug, slug will nothing be, but that it's a title with space, okay? Slug is nothing but a title with space. So if you say getting started with Pelican, we can just say getting started with Pelican as a title, but slug should be without space, okay? So install space, we can use dash. Install space, we can dash would be much better. And even viewing purpose, it'd be really nice, okay? So that's how we give slug, right? So other important things are here. Who's the author, what category it belongs to, and the content, my main content. Okay, so after giving the first few views, like what we do is, we give the main content, okay? So let me be a little specific about here in this case. Just a minute, I'll just change the view to this thing. What? So to be specific, what happens is, to be specific, what happens is, we have to give this few lines, okay? This few lines, which is very important. That is title, date, modified date, category, tags. Tags define what the blog basically is, okay? And then the author, fine. So this is what our like blog usually should will be. And I strongly suggest you to have a better summary here, okay? So what the summary is, if we have our blog post like this, this thing is there, no? This is a summary, nothing but summary, okay? So if you want our summary to be if you want, we can just put a small summary here. So here I have written short version for index and feed. That is nothing but here, which is here, short summary version for index and feed. Okay, so if you give a better summary, here we'll get a better summary. Okay, it all depends on us. Fine. So either we can give first few lines of the blog itself as summary. So it's up to you guys. See how which is feasible, which is feasible. Okay. And next, what we did was after creating a content, I mean blog post, we have to come back in the main directory. So let me just talk about that directory for some time. So how a directory looks is, we created something as Pelican, right? So guys, is my screen visible by first of all?
Yes, it is
Can someone
visible.
please Awesome. So let's say that I created a virtual machine known as blog. So blog is here. Under blog we'll have our repository, okay? This is Git repository. If you remember, we did Git clone, okay? So Git clone, and it got pushed in here. So in this repository is where this is our blog directory. This is our website directory, the main directory, okay? Whatever we are doing to do, we should do it over here. So to be specific, where should we create a post, blog post is inside content. So inside content we have to create it, okay? So here is the files, and what specifically we have to do is, we have to do Pelican. Okay, either we can just do Pelican, or we can do Pelican content. Nothing but here, the content. Okay, so that's the first step that we have to do. What it does is, it sees how many articles that we have in our website. Okay, that is what it does, the main agenda of it. Then it asks for make HTML. So the markdown files all gets converted into HTML files. To be honest, most of the time it's only for the first time we have to have both type, but after going ahead, we know it's both. Okay, if you want to be a good practice, just do Pelican space content first, and then the next step you can just do make HTML. Okay, so there's an another step, the third step. Okay, the third step, what happens is, we have to, if we want to run our website locally on the local host, what we have to do is, we have to do something like this. Okay, we have to say make and serve. So if I remember in previous session, what we did was, we talked something like idli, like how an idli is created and how idli is served to a person, right? So let me just take the same example. Okay, so Pelican content is nothing but oil haki, butter haki, ikkaro. Okay, Pelican make HTML is nothing but fire. Okay, so in next case, what happens is, we have to get chutney and all, no? So chutney ella ha maadi ready ki HTML maadiktare. Okay, na? So we are making HTML, we are making chutney, we are making chutney, we are making a chutney, we are making sambar. Okay, so idli ready de, sambar ready de, chutney ready de. So ye maabek serve maabeko. That is nothing but make serve. Fine. So we hope you remember these commands because it's very important. So what we have to do is, first is Pelican content. Okay. Oh shit! I am actually in the content folder. we have to be in the repository folder, okay? Only then Pelican works. Fine. So Pelican content is the first step. So what it does is it counts like how many articles are there. So there's one article here. If you see here, let me just increase the view so you guys have a better view. Fine. So the next step would be make HTML. Make HTML is nothing but what it does is just converts the markdown file into HTML file. To be honest, both does the same work but in a different manner. That's it. Fine. And then the next step would be make serve. Right. So what make serve does is it runs our website locally. So if you go to the site and then give, let me just go into new terminal, 127.0.0.1 and 8000. Okay, this is the port value. If you just enter, you will get into the blog post. Okay, this is our site. Fine. So this is in the default view, to be honest. So we'll get into deep. Okay. So till this is what we have done in the previous session. Okay. So let's talk about what we're gonna be doing in this session. Okay. Excited. I hope. Okay. So today's session we will mainly deal with hosting it. So this thing will be under glug-glugpse.gitlab.io. Okay. This website, which is over here, will be hosted there. Okay. That is the our agenda today, the plan today. Okay. So once that is done, we'll try to change the theme of this website. Okay. Once we change the theme of this website, we will try to see how to change this links, how to change the social, how to change this footer and all. And let's see how it goes. So that can be the final thing. And then we can just talk about the CryptPath for some time. And then we'll get back to Pelican and then talk what can we do as a future plan. So if Pelican, if you're going to get, what can you do in the upcoming days to have a better website? Okay. So the theme that I have selected is something known as Pelican Bootstrap 3. Okay. So that looks something like this. So this is what I am planning to get out of you guys. Okay. So this is how we will have our website running. I'm sorry, that was in localhost. I mean, I've already hosted it. So just let me give it to you. Okay, awesome. So this is the website. And if you guys see here, the website is hosted. Here, this is how the blog post looks. And here are the social links and all. If you get into the blog post, this is how the blog post looks. Okay. Seems nice. Awesome. So this is what our agenda for today would be. And let's start with it. Let's get started. Okay. So ready to go in? Okay, awesome. So guys, like there are a few things that I would like to tell you guys. So firstly, let me do Control C. Control C is nothing but it interrupts the keyboard interrupter. So any task running, any execution going on, it interrupts, it stops it. Okay, that's what Control C does in GNU Linux machine, right? So first thing that I would like to start with is, before getting into GitLab, like what we have to do is we have to have a three different files. Okay. The three different files are requirement.txt, gitlab-ci.yml, and then finally .gitignore. Okay. So these are the three files that we require. Okay. And before getting into it, there are a few changes that I would like to make here. Why Pelican GitLab? So Pelican takes a markdown file. You can take markdown and convert to HTML file. So I even take convert into HTML file. Where does it really save my file? It's a question of how that I can now. So where actually saves that? It's a first output. Okay? That's it.
Mukund, your voice is breaking.
Oh my God. Hello? now?
No, it is still breaking.
Oh, hell are you, man? Hello? Is my voice clear now? Awesome. So what specifically we are planning to do today is, I mean, by the way, where was I? What was I speaking? Someone is telling you. I tend to find if interruption happens. So can someone help me out? Like, what was I speaking about? Okay, Git 3 files. Okay, awesome. So there are 3 files, okay? So 3 files are requirement.txt, gitlab-ci.yml, then git ignore, okay? So before getting these 3 files, we have to do some small setups. The small setup is, we have to change the file from output into public. Why? Because GitLab is a platform, or GitLab is a platform which hosts our application, and it requires our application to be public always. So if it is not, like, at least, I mean, to be honest, it needs everything to be in public form. Okay. So to have it in public, we have to do one simple thing. That is nothing but we have to get into just let me know if my voice is breaking. Okay. We have to get into pelicanconf.py. Okay. Get into this file, go underneath and give this file name. Okay. So the file name is output path and output path equal to public. Okay. So the next step would be save it and then close. Okay. Save it and then close. Fine. And the next step would be get into publish. Okay. There's a file known as publish. So if you do ls in your main directory, you will have two files. That is pelicanconf.py and publishconf.py. Okay. So these two files are the one which we are trying to change, right? So the first thing is we have done with the pelican.conf. Now we have to do with publish.conf, okay? So once you get into this file, again the same step, add the output and underscore path equal to public, okay? Save and then exit. So now, the third thing that you have to do is we have to even get into another file which is known as make.html. Okay. Make file. So we have to get into this file, and here it will be output. Okay. So it will be output directory equal to dollar base directory slash output. Okay. This file we have to change it into public. Right. Save it and then exit. Fine. So I'll just repeat the 3 things that we have to do before getting into Git. That is, we have to get into publish.conf.py, add a new line, output I underscore r equal to public. Okay. And again, go to nano pelicanconf.py, add that is output underscore r equal to public. Okay. So once that is done, we have to get into make file. Okay. Nano make file. In make file, remember terminal is terminal deducts the characters. Okay. So if it is tab, then if you give small, it won't work. So it is character specific or something, we say, right? So we have to be specific about which character we use. Okay. So make is cap. So we have to get into make. file and then change make file. In make file, we have to change output directory into public directory. Okay, that's all. So once these three things is done, we can try to run Pelican. Okay, so what we have to do is we have to do Pelican content. Okay, and then we have to do make HTML. Okay, if you do this, there'll be a folder known as public created. Okay, if you can see here, there's a folder known as public created now. Now you can delete output file. Okay, so just get into your this thing, file manager, go and delete output. This is not required now. Okay, so it's as simple as that. So now what we have to do now is like, just let's cross check. Okay, it deletes it, but let's cross check. So now what we have to do is we have to create a dot GitLab file and dot git ignore file. Okay, I strongly advise you guys to do one thing. Okay, I will try to explain you what the dot GitLab file has, dot ignore file has, but try to copy it into the type, because you may come under it. So into blog, the blog is a blog. So what you have to do is, there is a thing which I have written here, right? We have to copy this and paste, okay? Because there will be an issue if you do any mistake over here, right? So first, let's create the requirement file. First, let's create a requirement file, okay? So why requirement file is there required? Like, we created something known as a virtual machine, right? So inside virtual machine, we'll be trying to try to install all the required software. So whatever the required software we install here, we have to make a note of it here. Okay. So just create a requirement file, that is nano requirement.txt, and then copy these two names there. What are all software that we install in our project, Pelican project? That is Markdown is one, Pelican is second. Okay. Right. Am I right? Yes. So go into your terminal, just do nano requirement.txt. And here give my Pelican and Markdown, okay? Simple. And then what we have to do is we have to create an GitLab file, okay? In GitLab -ci.yml, we have to keep this file, okay? And please remember one simple thing, don't make any mistake in the name file, because it's very important that we don't move any mistake of it, okay? So let me just go through in the file first, okay? So this is very important. So what is images? So it says first image. What is the image here? So image is nothing but here, it is Python over here, which actually says we are running a Python based a project. Okay. And then it says pages. So where is the GitLab pages to be hosted? So GitLab pages has a GitLab pages will be hosted in this path, which is given over here. Okay. So whatever path is given over here, it will be done there. Fine. So before that, I hope you guys understand what is script. So we even script is nothing but a type of language. Okay. So we call JavaScript because JavaScript is a scripting language. Script is nothing but it involves installations and all. Okay, installations. It even involves commands which allows them to run the file. Okay. So what, even Python, we can do scripting. Okay. Python is also a scripting language, not just an interrupt language, but even a scripting language. Okay. So first, what we have to do is we have to install whatever is in requirement.txt file. So what is there in requirement.txt? It is Pelican and then Markdown. So what happens is in the cloud, what happens is it will install Python first. Then it will install requirement, whatever things that are there in requirement.txt. And then it will run the file. So pelican-publish.conf. Okay, whatever it is there in publish.conf.py, it gets pushed into the site. Okay. So then it asks for artifacts. Artifacts is nothing but a path where we have to check things. Okay. So public, do you remember why I was telling public? So yeah, this is the reason. So most of the things that we have to have in public. Okay. That is why the reason I said make it in public. Okay, so whatever the output should be in public directory. So basically, whatever output we got, the HTML files all are in public directory. Okay, so then what we are doing here is the only means we have to check only in master branch. So at times what happens is our website may have lots of contributors. So there may be different branches involved. At that particular time, there may be chances of having a different branch. So that particular time, this may change. Okay, instead of master, it can be something different branch name, right? So only you have something known as master over here. So my advice is just copy till here, right click, copy, and then go to terminal, get into nano dot GitLab hyphen ci dot yml. Go there, control C, P, paste. Okay, once you do this, well and good. Okay, so let me get into what is gitignore. Gitignore is nothing but what and all we have to ignore in this particular thing. So at times, even though there is a mistake, we will ignore it. No, even though there is something which we tend to ignore, it will be there. No, something like that. Okay, so this public file will be ignored in the website. If you see, once we push all our code, source code into the Git, we won't have something known as public folder. But here we will have public folder. But once it is posted into the GitLab, it would be ignored. So that is what is known as gitignore. Okay. So in gitignore, what we need to have is we have to have public and then star dot pyc. Star dot pyc is nothing but it's a type of.
I think your screen is not visible.
Let me just check. So here, how many of you know shell scripting in the current current people who are attending the session? How many of you know shell scripting over here? So is there anyone who knows shell scripting? Yes or no? Guys? Anyone who knows shell scripting here? Oh my God, okay, awesome. So yeah, assume everyone knows shell scripting over here. Awesome. So I hope my screen is visible now. So why I ask shell scripting is, like, what happens is, usually if we want to ignore, I mean, if we want to view certain type of file, certain extension wala file, certain name wala file. I mean, how do I explain to you? So let's say that we have to view all HTML file in the terminal. Okay, so there's a folder. In that folder, all HTML file should be viewed, only HTML file. But in the folder, there's HTML, there's CSS, there's Python, there is JavaScript, there's Java, all type of files are there, even C, C++ and all. In that, only HTML file is what I want to view, I want to display. Okay. At that particular time, what happens is we have to do something like ls, okay, and then do star, and what is the view, what is the thing that we have to view. Okay, so let's say in this case, I'll just get into public folder. In public folder, I'll have HTML files and all. See, there are lots of HTML files. So if you see, there are many HTML files and there's four directories. Okay, there's many HTML files and their directories. Here, let me just view what is that HTML file. So what I have to do is I have to do ls star dot html. What it does is it will do ls, it will list only HTML files. See here, now there is no tag, there is no category, there is no author. Okay, so that's how we do. What it is nothing but it's a type of wild character. Star is nothing but an asterisk, which is a type of wild character. What it does is it checks all the files with this prefix. It checks all the files with this suffix. So based on the suffix you give, based on the prefix you give, it gives the values. Okay. And based on the command that you give. Here the command I give is ls. Okay. So let's get back to the session. Okay. Like, let me not move forward, very forward. So what I'm trying to do here is I'm doing git ignore. In git ignore, what and all we have to ignore is public and any file that ends with .pyc. To be honest, yes, we do have a file which is known as .pyc, which is here. Okay, apart from this, and this public file, all files would be visible in Git ka repository, Git ka project. Okay, to be honest, to be showing you the output, exact output, I'm just getting to the repository which I have hosted. Okay, so this is a repository which I have hosted. So if you see here in this repository, you won't find public, I mean you won't find PYC files. Okay, do you guys see any PYC files here? No, right? Why you see public file? I'll just explain to you, because I have not added public over here in this exit.not. Okay, that is why. Fine guys, awesome. So here in our case, we won't be doing that, same. Fine. So let's get back. So do you guys understood what and all we were trying to do here? So we try to create, first we try to change the files, that is publish conf.py, and then we went on to change after publish, we went on to change makefile, and then we went on to change pelicanconf.py, and then at last we understood that we have all things set up. Then we went into creating the required files for Git, hosting in Git, that are requirements.txt, then .gitlab-ci.yml, then .gitignore, okay? So these were the files that we required, right? So let me just, I hope you guys know Git push and all, what to push and all. So what we have to do now is very simple. Once you have made these changes, get into your browser, just do git add dot. Dot is nothing but it adds all the files, okay? So just to view or just to see, cross check, we have to do git status. I know I'm very bad at English, my spelling mistakes, typos, okay? So here it says that your branch is up to date because I've already pushed every file, right? So now what we have to do is git commit. Okay, let me do some change. Only then it will get respected. So let me create a, I hope you guys know how to create a post. So let me get into content. In content, let me create a file. So gedit, gedit also can be used to create a file. Okay, so I'm going to say second dot md. Okay, so I have a very bad memory, so I'm gonna do just copy paste. So sorry for doing this. So I'm just gonna do this copy paste from this. So here is a gedit which we try to get, paste it over here. We don't need the brs, so we can just remove the brs. So here, like what I have to change is, here the post, the title is not the same, so we have to change the title into second try. Okay, and here slug, I was telling, you know, whatever is the title, just give the title ka name. So second hyphen try. Okay, so what happens is this empty file, which is second try, will become second hyphen try dot html. Okay, I'll just show you the output over here. Okay, so I'll just save it. What I have to do is, can anyone repeat? Can anyone help me out with this? That is pelican content, right? You need to specify the path. Okay, awesome. So the mistake here is I have been into the content and then trying to get in run pelican, which actually is an error. We shouldn't do that. Okay, so just make sure that you do it in the website only, like the, when the website is there, no, this website repository, only there we have to do. Okay, remember that also. That's very important, by the way. So make HTML, then make HTML, what it is, it is make serve. Okay, so then it is make serve. So once make serve is done, we have to go and check in the localhost. So this is a localhost I'm already running. So here comes the second try. Second try is the next blog post, okay? So it is working. So let me just push it into Git, okay? I'll do Control C for interrupting. Git add dot for adding all files. Git status. So it says new file is added in content folder. The file name is second.md, okay? Understood? So I'm just going to do git commit. So it is git add, git commit, and git push. These are the three commands that we need to know in git. Okay? So git commit, hyphen m, and the message. What is the message? Added second blog post. Okay? Guys, am I fast? Do you want me to decrease my space? Anyone? So last is git push. Okay? So is anyone feeling that I am very fast? Do you want me to increase my pace? Anyone? Guys? Hello? Okay. So once you have pushed it, what happens is it will get pushed into the repository. Okay. So just get into repository, the UI part. And there we have to go into CI/CD. CI/CD is nothing but the place where our website is getting like it's a machine type, okay? Alle GitLab pages na configuration. Inside there, you have to go into pipelines. So inside pipeline, there's something called jobs, okay? So jobs na hook node there, it will show whether the job is running or it's been declined, it's been success, it's been failed or something. So based on that, React, okay? It will show a detailed list where, so you can just go and cross-check with it, okay? I hope my internet is very slow in this case, so that's why it's still loading. But to be honest, it just loads fast. And here you will see something like this. Not sure if I will put the pic of it here. Yeah, something like this, okay? So my internet is very slow, it's loading very late. Yeah, something like this, okay? So this is how it is, okay? It will be running, this will be in bloom color. Once it is successfully done, we'll get passed. Only then the website will be hosted, okay? I think still we have to wait for some more time. Yeah, here we get. So what happened is it was running here. See here, it is 24 seconds ago. Bad luck. So it said that it is 24 seconds ago it started running. So we got a green mark. We got a green mark with green marks and said it passed, which means we are able to host it successfully. So what we have to do is to cross check whether we have a site running under this name. We have to get into settings, pages. Okay. So once you click on pages, you will have a post ready, and there you will get a link like this. Okay. So here is the link, okay? So if you click this link, our website will be hosted over here. Right? Awesome. So here is the default blog site which we wanted to get. So here is the first post. Here you can go to home. And then here is the second try, okay? So these are the two things that we try to push into our website. Right? So let me tell that we are successfully hosted in GitLab. So till now, any doubts that you guys have, and please remind, let you know that we have lots of time. We can take it slowly also. So please let me know whether I'm fast also. So till now, all good to go. Did you guys understand? Any doubts?
No, Mukund, proceed.
Awesome. So now let's see how to get how to get themes done for our website. Okay, that's very simple. So what we have to do is we have to check whether we have themes in the server. Okay, so I went on to check the server and looking for themes. So I got very awesome themes like this and all. this is Bluedia, okay? This is Bluedia. Then I was just checking out the teams and all, and I understood that, to be honest, teams are very nice, and there are a hell lot of teams, okay? If you see, there are a hell lot of teams. So if you go to this link, which is github.com/getpelican, Pelican teams, this repository, you will find n number of teams there, okay? Just choose the best team that you like to have. And it's the same step that I'm trying to do. Like whatever I'm trying to do, it will be the same step for that also, right? But in this case, the best team that I liked was Pelican Bootstrap 3, because it was like most updated and it was really nice, okay? Because I really liked it. I mean, when I went into it, I was like, wow, that's so amazing. And it was having lots of features also in this. So it said that we will have our website something like in this format. Okay. This is how our website will look. Fine. So this is what the look had there. Then I was actually very amazed looking at it and then thought, let me just get it even my site. Okay. That's how I got it. So how do you get the, how do you get the themes to your machine? That is very simple. Okay. There are two things. One, you need theme, and then you need plugins. So plugins are nothing but what plugins are. Like it is basically nothing but it's like here and there are some changes there, you know, like tool types. Allige work there is that we have to use plugins, okay? So in this case, firstly we have to clone the repository. This repository we have to clone. We have to download this repository, okay? That's the first step. Second step, we have to clone the Pelican repository, I mean plugin repository. And where to clone the repository? Not inside the website, because there will be a hell lot of themes, there will be a hell lot of things which we want to clone. And if we download everything and put it in our own website, like it's not needed, right? Like bekagiro tagondre saaku, bekilliro tagondre en martira en illvala, right? So it's always better to have whatever we require, we get that, okay? So it's actually 30 MB, the themes, like it downloads all the themes. So how to download the themes is, we have to just get into the cd dot dot. Cd dot dot is nothing but it gets back into blocks alone. Okay, here I am trying to download git clone and then the this thing name. Or is this like Pelican themes ka clone ID, okay? So here, I think we haven't got into Pelican yet. So for simplicity, let me just use the website link, because I have given you a detailed one. So just copy paste it. It will obviously work. Okay. It will just obviously work. So just do this copy paste. So this is the path. Go here, then paste. And then it will work. Okay. It will download. It will take some time. Obviously, it will download. And since my internet is very slow and it takes around 30 MB, I'm not going to do this. Okay. Wait, it's quite fast. But since I've already downloaded it in my own repository, I'll just copy paste it. Fine. I'm just doing some demonstration purpose. I'm using it. So then what we have to do is we have to clone plugins. Okay. So same thing, just copy paste. It will work. Yes, this is also, I'm just executing, stopping the executing. Now what you have to do is we have to copy, at the place where I downloaded Pelican, see the Pelican themes and this thing will be, once downloaded will be something like this, okay? Pelican plugin, which is here, and then Pelican themes, okay, which is here. It has n number of themes over here, and here like there are n number of plugins. Okay, the plugin which we'll be using here is a separate plugin which I will actually tell you, but for now let's say that what the theme that we are going to choose is Pelican Bootstrap 3. Okay, so just search for Pelican Bootstrap 3, which is over here, right? I just saw it over here. Here, right click, copy, go back, go to okay, just a minute. It should be in blocks, okay? Not in, should be over here. So just go back to glugspac.kitlab.io. Here you have to paste it. Okay? We have to copy Pelican. Guys, understood, right? Like, we have to go to Pelican theme, search for Pelican, Bootstrap 3, copy it, come back, go to glugspac.kitlab.io, go here and then paste it. Paste it, done. Now the next step would be, we have to create a new folder, a folder known as plugin, plugins, okay? So in plugins, what we have to do is, we have to go into Pelican plugins, which is over here in the blog. And then here we have to search something known as i18n subsite. We have to just copy it. Is my voice breaking?
No, Mukund, no, no.
Awesome. So we have to just get into glugpac, blog-glugpac.kitlab.io, get into plugins, and then paste it over here. Simple. This is the two things that we have to do. One is clone the repository, the Pelican themes repository. Clone the plugins repository. So as soon as you clone it, you will have the both folders like this. Okay. And next step is go to Pelican themes, copy Pelican Bootstrap, go back to the website and paste it over here, which is your here. Okay. Then the next step is get into Pelican themes. I mean, not themes again, plugins. Here we have to copy something known as i18n subsites. What i18n subsites is nothing but it is the plugin that Pelican themes, the Pelican Bootstrap 3 theme is, you know, that theme requires. Fine, the theme is based on this type. What is that? Based on a type of plugin which is in this 18. i18n underscore subsite. Okay, am I clear or am I confusing you guys? Please let me know if I'm confusing you guys. So I hope I've not confused you guys. So now the final step, okay, that's the final step. That is nothing but we have to just put the themes, like what and all edits that we did. So we have to get into pelicanconfig.py file and then add this line. Just copy this, go to Pelican Nano, Pelican config. I should get into blog first. So here I have to do Nano, Pelican config. Okay, here I have to go underneath, okay, then paste it. So just copy paste would work. And here what happens is, what I'm trying to do is, I'm going to say the theme that I've chosen is Pelican Bootstrap 3. The Jinja environment, that is what I was trying to say. The Jinja environment is nothing but the plugin, okay. The plugin which is Jinja required is i18n, okay, that's the plugin. And where is this environment present? Is it's in a present in a path which is known as plugins, which is nothing but here, this plugin, okay? And the subfolder, there's a subfolder, right? So the plugin subfolder is nothing but i18n underscore subfiles, which is over here, okay? And then at last, we are going to say we need a banner, okay? A banner is a photo, okay? So what we have to do is, we have to get into contents. Here in contents, create a folder known as assets. Okay. Inside assets, have an image which is known as banner.jpg. Okay. So if the file extension is different, go to this file, change the extension over here. Okay. And if you want to have any message over here, just add the message over here. Okay. Then say static path. The static means nothing but it is the images, the CSS and all. Where is it? It is there in the assets. Okay. So you have to put this over here. Fine. Awesome. So once this is done, save it and exit. Okay. So once this is done, it means this is done. Setup is done. We have to now run and see whether it is working. So let's do Pelican content. Excuse me. make HTML. And at last, it's make serve, okay? So once you do this, what happens is, it runs in a local host. If you just go here, just go into the local host, you will have our website under the theme which we wanted, okay? Understood? Nice. So I've not added any image background. If I want, I can just add, but this is how it looks, okay? I'll just check whether I have some images first of all. Let me even put an image if you guys want. Should I put this? I think it's better to put this file. So I'm just gonna copy this file, get into assets, paste it over here, change the name of the file into banner. Okay, and then go into this go into nano, and then it is png. Okay, so I'm gonna change the name of the path here as png. Okay, I hope I'm not confusing you guys. Then here the message I'm gonna put is, welcome to Glug PAC blog post. Okay, I'm sorry for that. Welcome to Glug PAC blog post. Right, save, exit, again do Pelican config, again do Pelican make HTML, and then at last Pelican serve. Okay, so Pelican serve will run the file there. What is Ruby trying to do? I don't know. So, awesome. So now if you just get into the site, which is over here, just refresh, you will have an image right here. Amazing, right? I never expected this. Like, we have the college logo, we have the FSK logo, we have Glug logo. I never expected this, by the way. It's just a fluke, by the way. Awesome. So here is the blog site which you guys wanted. So here it says, welcome to Glug PAC blog post. And yeah, here it goes. This is what we expected. Now I want this to be hosted in the site. Okay. So git add dot, which adds all the files. Okay. Which adds all the files. Git status. It says how many plugins I've added, how many new files I've added, so many files, right? It's themes plus files, okay? And then at last, we have to do git commit hyphen m message. So the message is added theme for the site and plugins. I just say theme for the site, that's all, enough. For became throw here. I'm so sorry for the spelling mistake. I'm very bad at spelling, by the way. And then at last, it is git push. By the way, is the guy, is the message, is the terminal view right? Can you guys see the terminal? I hope you guys can see the terminal. So once you're done with this, it's done. So again, what happens is, we have to go into the pages. Then CI/CD jobs. In jobs, you will have the site running. Okay, you will have the exact site running. Whew. Okay, this is actually still running. So just wait for some time. Then as soon as this fish is here in the terminal, it comes up here as a blue mark. Okay, just look at it. Okay, done. Awesome. Here, if you just go and refresh, you will have the new job started. Okay. I've just refreshed it. Yeah, here it goes. So here it is running, and the status is still running. Okay, this is the status, this is still running. So now if you just get into the running thing, if you just click on the running thing, you will have an terminal based execution happening inside the GitLab pages, okay? So here you can see. So this is what means that we are trying to run the files, okay? Whatever happened in our terminal is the same thing which is happening in the GitLab repository, okay? So job succeeded. This says that our work is done and in this path, which is green in color, okay? So now if you just go into the pages, you will have the site running. You just get into the site, it will be here, and then just refresh, your blog post would be changed, okay? Sometime it may not reflect as soon as possible, but it may take time, okay? So GitLab pages is something which takes time. At max, it takes half an hour, okay? Here it goes, the site which we developed now, okay? So here we can just add any more blogs that we want. You can add any columns over here. Here the Python is the category. Here is the main path. So here it goes. This is the blog post that we have created using Pelican. And this is what I had today for you guys. So last thing that I would like to do is, like, I would like to change these things and all and change these things. So once this is done, we'll be done for the day. Okay. So the two things I want to discuss with you guys is first, how to change those things. I mean, those links, those social and all. You can even have better name, like not link, not social, but we can have better name. But what to have? We should be very specific on that, okay? So once that is done, we have to, like, I'll just talk about a futuristic plan that we can do on this site, okay? So just give me a minute. I'll just drink some water and come. Guys, any doubt till now? You guys have any doubt? Is there something which I missed to explain, which you guys didn't understand? Or it's good to go, so I just go forward. Good to go?
Yes, Mukund.
Okay, awesome. So awesome, guys. So let me continue. So, see, basically, where you have this file is, we have something known as published, no? If you just get into the file here, our Pelican site files, we have something known as make file, which is the one which does everything for us, Pelican conf. Okay, just let's see what's there in Pelican conf. Okay, I've never done that to you, right? This is what is known as source code reading. Okay. So here it says the author is GlugPAC, right? No, this is the name which we gave. The site name is GlugPAC blog post. If you want, I can just change it over here. It gets reflected back there. Okay. And then the path where we have all the files is content, correct? And then the time zone, the language that we chose, it's a feed and all. And then it says links and social. Do you guys remember where we saw links and socials before? By the way, guys, do you want me to do it in a white screen or something different color? Like, is it visible properly? Should I change the view or is it visible, guys? Pritam or someone, can someone tell me? ಇದು ಕಾಣಿಸಿದೆಯಲ್ಲ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ನಾನು ಚೇಂಜ್ ಮಾಡಲ್ಲ ಕಲರ್ನ
ಕಾಣಿಸಿದೆ
ಆಸಮ್ ದಟ್ ಸೊ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಥಿಂಗ್ ಆಸಮ್ ಆಸಮ್ ಸೊ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಥಿಂಗ್ ಇಸ್ ಸೋಷಿಯಲ್ ಓಕೆ ಸೊ ಲೆಟ್ ಸಿ ವಾಟ್ ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಇನ್ ಸೋಷಿಯಲ್ ಸೋಷಿಯಲ್ ಇಸ್ ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಆಡ್ ಲಿಂಕ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ಯುವರ್ ಕಾನ್ಫಿಗ್ ಫೈಲ್ ಅಂಡರ್ ಸೋಷಿಯಲ್ ಲಿಂಕ್ ಓಕೆ ಹಿಯರ್ ಇಸ್ ದ ಕಾನ್ಫಿಗ್ ಫೈಲ್ ಐ ಮೀನ್ ಹಿಯರ್ ಇಸ್ ದ ಕಾನ್ಫಿಗ್ ಫೈಲ್ ಓಕೆ ಸೊ ವಾಟ್ ಈಸ್ ದಟ್ ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಇನ್ ಅವರ್ ಸೋಷಿಯಲ್ ಲೈಕ್ ವಿ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಆಡ್ ಮೆಥಡ್ ಆನ್ ರೈಟ್ So how we have to do is, we have to, this is the first inverted comma is the name, okay? It will get reflected over here. I mean, like this, okay? The second one is the URL, okay? So I'm just putting here Mastodon. Can someone help me with what is a Mastodon username for GlugPAC? I think Nirbhay can help me out. Nirbhay, do you have the Mastodon link for Glugby Sika thing? Nirbhay? Okay, so let me just search in our Glugby Sika thing. We have a long chat. We may have something. Okay, so I think our Mastodon ID is Club PAC something, no? Just give me a minute, guys. I will just take the Mastodon link. I just want to add a right link, okay? Just PNN on Akadan Bistagila. So it is. It is nothing but here in the ask, what we have to give is at the rate. Glug PESCE at the rate Mastodon dot social. Okay, is my screen visible?
Yes,
okay, yeah, here it goes. So, is there anything else that we can give, guys? Anyone have any other point to add? Can add Twitter, no? So for Twitter, it is glugpac. The username is glugpac@9. Okay. So for now, let's say that this is the link. I mean, I should add twitter.com. No, what is Twitter? I don't know what is the extension of Twitter, but I'm not used it. So let's say twitter.com. Okay. And a person like Mukund would try to add something like website also. Okay. So here I add a website. So Glug PSC website. Okay. Right. So what is the website URL? It is Glug. PESC.github.io, right? So if you want, you can just add https://call this thing. So it will work out really well. So here it goes. Okay. So social, I'm done. So link here. So let me just remove Pelican. I'll add Glug PSC again. I don't know what else to add. So I'm just adding it. Okay. It's not that, for publicity sake or something, right? Here I'm adding our college car thing. Okay, PSC. I mean, let me add PSC website, right? And here, what is the college website ID? PSC Mandya, no? .org, if I'm not wrong. So here, let me add FSMK ka thing website. So FSMK website is FSMK.org, okay? Right, awesome. So here I don't want this, so I'm just gonna remove it. Right, so this is what we wanted and we're done with it. So let me guys, just a minute. Yeah, so I hope it works. So let me just save it. You guys think I have to do git add? Yes, we have to do git add. But before git add, we have to do Pelican because it's very important we do Pelican. It's Pelican content. Wait, there's an error here. It says syntax error in pelican.config.file. So syntax error obviously would be here. Let's see where is the syntax error. So here somewhere we have made a mistake. Can someone just check where I have done the mistake? It says that I've done a mistake. Okay, here I think. So he can't have I think let me just have PSC. I'll not have S. I think it's right now, no? Yeah, the error that I had was I had three hyphens instead of two. So that was an error. Okay. I hope you guys are understanding what I'm trying to do. Okay. So this is the process done. So now we have to do make HTML and then we'll be done. Let's not get into serve because serve is just going to run it in host localhost. So let me do git add dot with at all files, git commit m. And then here I'll say changed pelican.config, right? pelican.conf.py file. So why I'm doing all this messages? See, by chance, if I've done any errors, okay? Like in future, if I want to correct it, I'll know where to check for the errors. See, Igor, I have done this commit. In this commit, I have done the error in this particular part. So I'll go there and do the check. Okay. So that's why I'm going to go there only. Then git push at last. And then we need to give some time around 5 seconds so that it runs in the, it runs back in our GitLab. And then we will have our site running with the proper links. Okay. So any other changes that you guys specifically want me to do here? Anyone, is there anything that we want to make so that I can just teach you? This is what I had in mind. So footer, you can just go right down and just change the footer. It's not an issue. Footer will be in somewhere in the themes. Okay. So is there anything else that you guys want me to help you with? Should I go one by one? Start with Samru, start with Nilvay, start with Peter. You want me to go like that? So yeah, it's running over here. It's passed. So if you just go into the website, just do one F5, it will refresh. And here you'll have the website changed. Okay. I mean, what? Okay. Just a minute. I'll just cross check. Either the file wouldn't have got updated. That's the only thing. Okay. Just let me just cross check before doing it. So I just want to ask you guys, is there anything that you guys want me to specifically do edit, change, so that you guys can understand what I'm trying to do? Anyone? Okay, Pritam, just let's start with you. Do you want me to change anything? Hey, wait. I think I have not saved it properly. Let me save it. Pritam, let's start with you. Is there anything that you want me to change in the website now?
No, if anybody wants, let us know.
Awesome. So who's next then? So who goes next? So Nirbhay. Nirbhay, do you want anything to change over here? So here it's updated. This is social. In social, we have GlugPSC website, Mastodon, Twitter, and then in links, we have GlugPSC, PSC website, FSLK website. Fine. So it does work. Okay. Like it's not that I'm fooling you guys. It works. Fine. Here goes our FSMK site. I love the FSMK site, you know, it values so much for localization. Each and everything has an localized thing. Nice, no? Maybe we should come up with something like this. Yeah, forget like what FSM website does, but let's get into what we are going to do. So yes, tell me guys, though, anyone who wants me to change anything here, there, or something like that. Wow. In fact, I even have in Kannada, man. I didn't know this. Okay, guys. So this is what I plan to have it today. So here it goes. So this officially almost ends the Pelican session because I am yet to talk about the future plans that we can try to do this. If you don't mind, I can finish this and then get into the CryptPad session. What do you say, Pritam? Shall we go to CryptPad and then come back to the futuristic plan of Pelican, or we will finish futuristic plan and then go to CryptPad? What do you suggest? Pritam? Pritam, what do you suggest? Let's go to CryptPad or let's finish and then go to CryptPad?
What?
No, what I'm trying to say is, I'll just take another 5 minutes, okay? So I'll just finish, I'll finish the futuristic plan for Pelican here and then let's go to CryptPad. Oh, okay. Discussion on CryptPad, or yeah, can we have CryptPad now? Awesome. So the futuristic plan for our website or Pelican would be add more content. So you know how to add more content. So go to contents, add new files, create new files, and then URL files. Okay. So what is Markdown? Okay, Markdown is basically a file where you can use iPhone. You can use. Let me just show you an example. Okay. So this is just an example, okay? This is where I built my website. This is another, nothing but a CryptPad, okay? So here, what happens in Markdown is, Markdown is a very simple language. It's a type of language, okay? Here, if you use, what do we call that symbol as, guys, like hash? Is it hash itself or is it some other name? So if you use two hash, that's a different thing. If you use three hash, it's a different type of header. If you use one hash, it's a different type of header. It's something like H1, H2, H3, H4, okay? Then that's one of the syntax. Second syntax is, you can use the symbol, which is above escape button, which is below escape button. That we can use for making the text, the content text as a code, looks like a code, okay? So something like this. Okay, the pink one looks like a code, no? This and this are different. So to make this into a code, I've used that symbol. And then here to come down, I have used 1, 2, 3, one dot space. So it's a very simple language. Just start writing blocks. That's the best thing that I can suggest you. So this is all the same way I've written. Then I pushed it into the repository and then it comes to the GlutPAC website, okay? This is how I have done that. So it's up to you guys. If you guys are hosting your website, please let me know. You know whom, like, you know my Telegram handle. This is my Telegram handle. This is my email ID, okay? If you want to contact me on Mastodon, contact on Mastodon. I'll help you out, okay? Surely I will help you out. So that's the things that I want to say. So adding more content, here is how we add content. Like just use Markdown. That's the best thing that you can use. Now we have used a theme which is most popular. Okay, but see if you like some other themes. Just use the theme and see if you like it. Else, if you want to change the same theme into some other color or background color, text or something. Like here it is in blue in color. No, so if possible, try to change this into black. Try to change this content into red. See how you want to change it. Okay, so that you can try to do. So try to change the theme for a while. Try to have a different look to your website. Then you can try to add a start search button. Okay, so somewhere here you can just have a search button. It's very simple. Somewhere here you can have a search button. If someone wants to search the website post, like let's say Pelican is here in this post. If they click here Pelican, it will come and search. You can even add that. That's JavaScript, okay, to be honest. You can use JavaScript and a few HTML CSS. It will be a good one. Then you can add something like comments. So comments will come and discuss. So that's the one big thing which you can do. So just try it out, okay? Just see how you can just try to have this website hosted. One thing that we can do is we can use Pelican for even a profile making. So I'm just gonna show you one website which is like a profile type. So if you see this website, this is something like a profile type which is built in Pelican, okay? This is actually built in Pelican. So then we have something into blog. So this inside this blog, this is completely Pelican. Okay, there's an error here, but that's connecting error, not a real error. Okay, so here this is how the website looks. Okay, nice, no? This is one website which I really love. This is hosted in Pelican, to be honest. Okay, this is hosted in Pelican. So this is the plans that I have for my website. So to be honest, even my website is the same path. Maybe in upcoming days, let me try to change some things. Change the background themes and all. Let me come back to you guys. So I've written the tags as Foss, Python, Giveback, Phoenix blog. Okay. So this is what I planned for you guys. So thank you guys. Thanks for being part of the session. I hope every one of you will get a Pelican-based blog site ready. And please let me know if you have any issues. If you build a very better website than mine, just let me know. Just send me the pic. Screenshots. Let me even have a look at it. If there will be some, obviously something that I should learn from you guys. So it's all on the part of learning. Okay. So I hope I made sure that in this lockdown, period, I made sure you guys all have an productive lockdown where we have been learning things. So this is what we were planning things. And thank you guys. Thanks for attending. And let's get into CRISPR for now. Let's have a discussion over there and let's end the session. Thank you. You can take over, Peter. Pritam? Yeah, just Pritam.
I am sure.
Awesome. Just you can continue, man. Thank you.
Yeah, thank you. Thank you. Okay, guys, I am Pritam. Today I want to discuss about CRISPR. I will share a link in the chat box so you can go through that. I think everybody can go through that. Yeah. Today it is a FOSS tool. First of all, CRISPR is a FOSS tool, completely open for us. It is an online document editing tool. For offline editing, you will all know LibreOffice. Even it sends the privacy issues, it encrypts the data of the type which you ensures the data, and even it is also encrypted from the client side, so even though they can't access your data. It has started some around couple of years, maybe it started at something, I think it's 2014 it started. It is a project for some of the students, and it came up with a CRISPR. And instead of receiving the, then you all probably will all get, are you all in this screen, or you all are opened that link, so you can go through. The picture is there, CRISPR, and I wanna tell something more on CRISPR now. Okay, fine. And they're having many issues. It's a pretty good here. There are similar kind of to compare to other tools. Most of all similar. I don't want to tell what is Word now or what is PPT, or I don't want to review the basics now. You can visit the official website to start using it. It's CRISPR.fr, or yeah, you can go through it. Even you can use the CRISPR without registering, so you can use without sign up. And if you enter into a CRISPR or you are using the CRISPR without registered, then you can store the data around 3 months so that it's safely stored. And there is a even though they don't ask any information when you are registering a create pad. One minute, please. Sorry for the challenge. So that you don't have many issues, and even they don't ask any information of you. They only ask what should be your username, and they ask password. That's it. They don't want to know your information. Even they don't have time for that. Even though don't have storage for them, so they don't ask anything of your information. They ask only to what should be your username and what should be your password, and you can access whatever you want when you are registered. And there are three types of features here. That is anonymous, registered, and premium. Anonymous is nothing but whoever can be used, which can be stored only for 3 months. The registered thing is, the thing is registered, but you can be stored up to however you want. And the storage limit will be 1 GB. And premium thing, yeah, it's good. The premium thing is something called a paid version. So you will have a doubt on that. You are saying a first tool, but even though you are telling premium, what's that? Okay, fine. The people who are running this, they have to do some scenario, or they want to know function, or they want to create an event. They want some amount. So that premium will be going through that. And premier thing is something called for it having something up to 5 GB to 50 GB. Some it's paid version. I will share the link also for that one. And rich text is something for word processor. Code is for code editing programming. Presentation, you all know it is PPT. Poll, it's to create a poll and get to know. And whiteboard is for drawing. So that the CryptPad as goes on like this, and I will share a link for to register a CryptPad to, I think everybody can register it. Don't ask any information of you. And I will share you the link of difference between the anonymous user, register user, and premium user. Okay, guys, wait, let me share my screen. I think my screen is shared. Yeah. Fine. Yeah. I shared the CryptPad in this format. See, you can see whatever you want and you can edit it, but I send I send only read only, so that you can only read it, you can't edit it. And even I can share this link also, it's not an issue. Even though it's in real time, if I change here something like this, even though it's changed in that read only, also it's a real time. Whatever you changed, it will also change in real time, so it won't take any time. And it can be edited whatever you want, having some of the tools here, whatever you want. You can use font style, something like that. And see, here is a share option. See, we can be shared like this. It's a link, or it's an embedded, or it's in contact. If it's in a link, it can be view version or edited version. So that view version can be only read only. You can read it, that's it. Edit, you can edit it, whatever you want. And even you can see that the changes in the link. Oh, if you do the changes, view, edit, something like that, it will get to know. And there are many things. And you will get to know how many people are seen like this user, how many people are seen this. So if you will get to know all such things. And yeah, this is the CryptPad. It's all are inside in the CryptPad. Rich text, sheet, code, something like this. Rich text is same as this, and sheet is nothing but see here. Yeah, and see, you can the Yeah, this is a CryptPad, so you can wound or expire or add a password, whatever you want, you can do. Create just, that's it. Yeah, this is something called sheet, and whatever you want to do, just press Control E, it will show all the things, something like this. Yeah, something like this, it shows like this. Whatever and rich text, code, presentation, poll, you want to make such decisions, or you want to take a fast decision, you don't have time, so that you can put a poll here, and whiteboard is for drawing. So something like this, CryptPad is making it's having CryptPad can be used only for 50 MB. Due to Corona or COVID-19, they have extended it up to 1 GB now. So it's an amazing thing. Whatever you can be stored in the cloud itself, even though you can be stored in your system also. And if you can share the document also, even you can share the link also, whatever you want, or what are the convenient to the users, so they can do whatever they want. And CryptPad is a only online thing, so that in LibreOffice, whatever you changes, you can send only the document. But here you can share the link also. And even though here having some chat box here, yeah, whatever you want to chat here, you can chat it and you can send it there. So that it shows our name, date, and what have typed, so that people can get to know that what he had done, or if I made any changes in this document, you get to know, I will share here, I changed something, I changed the topic somewhat. I have chat, or it can be whatever the chat should be. And you can share for many people the link also. And the thing is, only the three users, the thing is anonymous registered, and premium, better to go through the registered one, so that it won't ask anything. See here, I think I will show that one. Yeah, something like this. It asks only name or weight. Yeah, whatever you did here, it's all stored in this way. See, I have used only 0.01 GB used out of 1 GB. So this is the storage amount. You can see newly, or you can use new also, whatever you stored, it's all here. And the thing is, I want to share something. This is Excel sheet. And the thing is, you can, another option, log out everywhere. If you log in another phone or another laptop, you can be logged out at a time, so that you can have it. And even you have profile setting, you want to change your display name, whatever you want, you can do. Even though you can have a contact here, see here is a contact option, so that you can save your contact, even though you can chat with them, even though you can share directly whatever did in the your documents, so that it's are more easier to. I don't have any friend in contacts. Don't think so bad, it's CryptPad, so I don't send a request for them. If you want a contact for them, you should send a request for them, and they should access it, or they should confirm it to you. Then only both of you can chat, or both of you can do whatever that in the chat option. And the thing is to do, what to do. The thing is, there's something like to do. It's something like, it's an 13th May session I have to do, what to do. So I have kept 13th May session, so I can remember such things. And you can file it. Whiteboard is nothing but a drawing board, something like drawing sheet. You can draw whatever you want. And the Kanban, the thing you can do is, see here, I can save here 13th May. Okay, that's it. Here you can say 13th May sessions are going on. It's processing. Oh, it's end. So something like that. You can enter by step by step. And I said about poll, even though what is presentation? Presentation is nothing but PPT, that's it. Code, it's about something like everybody's know, even the sheet, and rich text, I explained it. Yeah, some crypt pad is something like this. I think. Oh my god, my voice is breaking. When? Is it okay now? Okay, fine. Yeah, fine. And I think I explained all of the thing in CryptPad. And even though CryptPad has a drive so that you can save, or you want to do something in it, you want to save some files, so you can have here also in the drive. Even though I explained in last session something disroot drive, even though you can, I think I explained disroot cloud, I think, so that even though you can save your documents or your files in the both, I think even though it's having 1 GB up to 1 GB, whatever you want, you can do. And the thing is here, yeah, see, you can see the what are the features between how the access between the anonymous user and registered user, premium user. You will get to know everything. Something I think one or two are difference between anonymous to registered user. And the premium user, you don't want to worry about that. If you want 5 GB, create 5 accounts and you can make that. So don't waste your money, I suggest. And I think I have covered all the topics, or I covered more about CryptPad. So that have any doubts, and every session end with one question and every with one answer. What is any doubts? Everybody say no. Don't say that. If doubt, please let me know.
I'd like to just add one point, okay?
Yeah, please.
So that is, in CryptPad, like if you just get into CryptPad, like any one of the CryptPad, where let's say code or let's say rich document, just start typing, okay? Just start getting into, just start working on the document. Let's say example, you're gonna write a Python script or Python code for creating a it's gonna do some task, okay? The task is it's gonna convert an image into a PDF, okay? Let's say that we have an image, that image is gonna get converted into PDF, okay? That's the task we have. That's the code we have written, okay? That code, what happens is, if we want to type the code, let's type the code, take some time and then close the pad and then go later, okay? And someone else, you have given the link, okay, to edit, the option to edit. So once you share, if you want to share, you can share it in three ways. That is, you can share it as a presentation itself. You can share it as a view. You can share it as a edit, okay? And these are three ways you can share. And there are ways that you can even put this code as an embedded in websites also, okay? That's the way it provides us the way. And the best part of this is, you're given the edit option code to someone, know the link to someone, know if that someone, let's say that I am going to edit a code for Python and I've given the link to Preetam, my editor, and then he did a mistake. And then Nirbhay pitch in and Nirbhay tries to correct it. And then Samrud comes in, Samrud again tries to correct it. Okay. And then it just goes on. And somehow I was not aware that it all happened at all. Okay. Then I come in and I see like what and all changes have made. And then I see I'm gone confused. Like, because I'm not sure how it's been coded. Okay. Now what I can do is I can do trace back in CryptPad. So there's an option where it shows history, who and all came in, who and all edited, what they edited, and there's a way that we can get back to the old code where I started. I left the code. That's how CryptPad is so good. That's one of the best features I liked it. Just want to add this point. So anything that you wanted to add, Preetam?
Raise your vote on that.
Anything you wanted to add apart from this?
No.
Awesome then. So then shall we just wind up our session? So guys, do you have any doubts? If no doubts, we'll just wind up the session. Doubts there, Kelly, solve Martana. Shall
I
we then
think they
close
don't
then?
have any doubts so that we can wind up now.
Awesome then. So fine then, guys. Thanks for attending today's session. So there's one last session which we're gonna conduct, okay? That's on design. That's on design. Okay, so we're gonna conduct a poster making event. Try to attend it and let's see how it goes, okay? So that's the last session for our Glug online sessions. So let's see. There's an person from FSMK coming, gonna speak. So along with him, there's a person from Glug PSC who's gonna speak. So let's see how they take the session and let's have fun, okay? And since it's gonna be last session, we'll have lots of things to do. And yeah, guys, so thanks for attending today's session and let's see how it goes in next session, okay? Thank you. Thanks a lot. Bye-bye.
Okay guys, let's wind it up. Bye bye, have a nice day.
No, no, no.